Good afternoon and welcome to Virtual Couponing for Beginners. Hi, my name is Christine Pugh and I will be your instructor for today. First of all, let me tell you a little bit about our services. We offer the various services that's listed here, peer advocates, which are our outreach services, which conducts our health huts and our wellness programs, wellness workshops as well, HIV testing and risk reduction counseling. I do HIV testing and counseling here on Wednesdays with scheduled appointments. Just call our office at 407-823-5841 to schedule an appointment. And I'm also downtown on Tuesdays offering the same HIV testing and counseling services as well. HIV testing is free for students and anyone in the community who wishes to be tested. We also offer biofeedback assisted relaxations training as well, which teaches you how to handle stress. GPS wellness coaching program, which is a wellness coaching program where you're assigned a wellness coach to help you throughout the semester. Also listed in the services with GPS wellness coaching is SNAPS. SNAP is a food stamp program where if you need assistance with helping you eat healthy, you can schedule an appointment with me as well. And my email address will be shown here after the program. Also, we have Fresh You cooking demos and classes. There is a virtual cooking class that's offered tomorrow via Facebook. So go to follow us at our Facebook at Healthy Nights, and you can sign up to follow the cooking class as well as the virtual couponing classes that will be offered throughout the semester. And here is the fall schedule for our services that is being offered here. And if you have any other questions, you may call our office 407-823-5841. Or if you'd like to email me at christine.pugh, that's P-U-G-H, at ucf.edu. And here is the virtual couponing classes for the fall for couponing 101. All right, let's get started. This is who I am. I have over 20 plus years in couponing experience. I'm also the sexual wellness coordinator. Like I said, I do HIV testing and counseling as well as SNAPS program. And our objectives for today will be COVID-19 couponing tips, couponing supplies needed, when, where, and how. What are coupon inserts and where to find them? Coupon insert schedule and coupon lingo terms. All righty. As you begin to start couponing, you will notice that majority of the stores, you have to wear your mask. So mask up before entering the stores. Also sanitize your hands upon entering and leaving the stores. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, or mouth with unwashed hands. And remember to stay at least 6 feet away from others while shopping in line. Also, stores have marked or areas in the stores whether you follow the directions of the arrows that's placed on the floors. This is to keep you at least 6 feet apart from individuals. And also remember, while out couponing, only touch the products that you plan on purchasing, if possible. These are some helpful tools that you will need when you decide to start couponing. You will need a printer. This is basically used for printing your online coupons. You'll need a laptop or a computer to join Facebook's groups that you will learn about further in the classes. Also, a plastic file folder with dividers and labels. Store flyers, which you can find in your local newspapers. The El Sentinel, which is free. And if you choose to make a subscription to a newspaper, which is the Orlando Sentinel here in this area, you can subscribe for coupons through the Orlando Sentinel. Or if you choose to purchase a newspaper, Orlando Sentinels are $4. Scissors for cutting your coupons. And I also suggest a pen or a highlighter just in case you forget your items or you need to remember to jot down an item that you was not in stock, because presently they're not offering rain checks at the present time. When, where, and how. When to set aside a date and time that you like to start couponing. I suggest not couponing on the weekends if this is your first time couponing, due to the simple fact that this is the busiest shopping days for individuals who tend to do their grocery shopping on the weekends. Where, choose which store you would like to start couponing in. I would suggest Publix, due to the simple fact that Publix has a lot of BOGO items that you can choose from. And if your coupon says a percentage off any one item, that means you can get to use two coupons. So how, the amount of time you're looking to commit to couponing, and how much you're looking to save. So if you're looking to commit 2 to 3 hours couponing, more than likely you will save anywhere from $10 to $20 a purchase. It's more, the more time you commit, the more savings that you could possibly receive. Yes, and you can get certain items for free with coupons. Your coupon inserts. You have three individual coupons that come in your daily newspaper. Here, as listed on the screen, you have your Smart Source. This is distributed weekly or bi-weekly in your newspapers. I do have a schedule that's attached, and you'll see that schedule shortly, that tells you when these coupons are in the paper. Okay, Smart Source. You also have a Retail Me Not. This is also published weekly or bi-weekly in your papers as well. And you have your Procter and Gamble. This particular insert here is published monthly. So it usually tends to be in the paper around the end of the month or at the beginning of the month. And this is where you'll find all your laundry detergent as well as your personal items in the Procter & Gamble. Anything that's produced by Procter & Gamble, which is PG, is published once a month. And where do you find these coupons? Like I stated before, in your, here in this area will be your Orlando Sentinel or L Sentinel. Orlando Sentinels cost $4 a piece. You can either get the early edition on Saturday or pick up your regular Sunday paper on Sundays. L Sentinels, they are free and they're distributed throughout the area. Here on the east side of Orlando, I've found a store, the 7-Eleven, that's down by McCulloch and the Dollar Tree in that plaza. They have the Orlando L Sentinels there as well, and they're free. And sometimes you can check your junk mail. You can receive coupons in the mail as well. So don't just throw that junk mail that comes in your paper in the trash. Have a tendency to go through it and make sure there's not any manufactured coupons in there. Okay. And this is that coupon insert. If you would like this coupon insert, email me and I will email this insert to you. It keeps you from having to go and buy a Sunday paper when there's not going to be any coupons in that paper. So this is similar to like a cheat sheet that you can use to know when to purchase the newspaper. And Coupon Lingo, which is a rarely great item to have if you choose to join the Facebook groups that I will have you following on Facebook, and it keeps you from having to spell out, like, for example, here shown AC after coupon. You would just put AC, then individual would know that you're trying to figure out what can you do after the coupon. And it has others from A to Z. So it has lingo from A to Z for you to learn how to correspond back and forth on these various groups on Facebook, and sometimes with your friends if you choose to pick up a friend to go couponing with as well. And this one here is a little smaller version. I would suggest, if you're new to couponing, that you print this off. I can email this to you as well. Print this off and keep this in your purse with you. For instance, as a kid, you might have thought that little blinking machine that was in down the aisles blinking was a toy that you played when you probably took several coupons out of it. But actually, that was money, a percentage off coupons that you could use toward a purchase. So this is a little handy tip that you can print and put in your purse to tote around with you as well while you're in the process of learning how to coupon. Also, there is a survey that I need you all to do for me. We will email the link out to you as well. Also, questions. If you have any questions, please, please, please ask questions. That's what I'm here for, to help you learn how to coupon. Just put those questions down in the comment box and they will be forwarded to me, and I'll be more than happy to answer those questions for you all.
Ms. Christine, we did have a few questions come in, and I'm going to go ahead and ask those to you if that's okay.
All right. Thank you, Chrissy.
You're welcome. So how did you actually originally get into couponing? What started all of this for you?
All righty. I started couponing many, many moons ago when I was in undergrad school. Just being by myself, having no one. I had a support system, but sometimes, you know how your parents may not have money to send you. So I said, let me figure out a way how I can cut my grocery bill in half or to smaller cost. So that's how I started couponing, and I've been couponing ever since.
Awesome. The next one that came in was, what stores do you usually coupon at, and do you have a favorite and why?
Okay. I coupon at various stores, Publix, Target, Walgreens, Walmart, Dollar General. I don't necessarily just coupon at grocery stores. I coupon at department stores. Any store that offers any rewards or coupons, I'm there. About 3 years ago, 3 or 4 years ago, I won a coupon for $100 off a purchase at JCPenney's. So I suggest that you register for any store that has rewards programs. Register. You will see that coupon 20%, 30%, or even for your birthday, some stores happen to send you $5 or $10 off a purchase. So register for all rewards that are offered at stores.
Awesome.
Any other questions?
Yes, we do. How has COVID-19 and this pandemic affected your couponing and your coupon hauls?
Okay, COVID has. COVID kicked in March. So I stopped couponing due to the fact that some stores had limited items that you could only get. So when I'm usually couponing, when it was normal, back in the normal, I would go in and get my max 8 items. So now that has been cut down to either 2 items or 1 item. So I basically just started back couponing in August this month. I just started back couponing, and it's still certain items that still have a certain limit, or some of the items are not even in stock. So COVID has really hit couponers very hard, but we're bouncing back slowly but surely. We will be back. So my stockpile will start back getting larger. So yes, it did affect me a little.
All right. And we just actually had a new question from Scarlett come in on Facebook. How much do you usually save a year with coupons?
Scarlett, I really haven't sat down and figured that one out, but if I can save $10 every trip, and sometimes I coupon 2 and 3 times a week, or before COVID hit, I coupon every day. So if you multiply 10 times, just say $10 each trip, 10 times 4 weeks in a month, that's $40. Times 12, you should come up to be what, $480?
Fabulous. Is there a specific date that you like to coupon every week, or do you have a day that you usually like do your prep for couponing and then a day you go shopping? What's that schedule look like for you?
I don't have a set schedule since I'm an expert couponer. But I would choose tell you to set aside a date and time. I used to have a date and time when I used to just sit and cut all my coupons out, and I had a tendency of having coupons that expired because I had too many coupons and had forgot what I had. So normally what I do is grab an ad in the store or go online to that particular store's website and see what they have on sale, as well as following the groups that I have in my groups list that's other couponers. And they helps out a lot. It cuts down on a great deal of your time. So if you know this one particular item is going to be in the store free, that's what you're going to get free. You're going to get free, or you're going to pay the tax, which is minimum tax. I'll give you an example. There's an item that's on sale this week at Publix. It's the Purcell laundry detergent, and there's a $2 off coupon, and it was on sale in Publix for $3.99, and you're getting $2 off. So I basically pay $1.99 plus tax. So that was like $2.54 for laundry detergent that normally runs $5.49 for the 15 count pods, which I thought was an awesome deal, but the coupon did set a limit one. So that means I had to go to various Publix to actually get my 8 laundry detergents.
Awesome. And thank you for giving us that example. That's super helpful.
Thank you. Thank you, Scarlett.
Yes. And Ms. Christine did mention that she does Publix a lot, and she helps moderate for us on social media. We do a weekly post called Publix Hot Deals of the Week. We post those usually every Thursday or Friday, but you'll want to follow us on Instagram for that, at Healthy Night. And she goes over some of the best deals for the week at Publix. So that's super helpful for you if you shop there regularly.
Yes.
And then also, Ms. Christine, this kind of segues into our next question. You mentioned that you use some couponing groups. Do you usually coupon by yourself, or do you have a group of friends that you do that with, or is it people you've met via social media? How did you get involved in those groups?
These groups that I follow are groups that were suggested by some of my other couponing friends. I do sometimes go couponing with others, and if I stayed in the area, I would recommend you follow me to the grocery stores and I would teach you how to coupon. I stay in Polk County. So I have a friend that usually goes when she's trying to get her stockpile up, but normally I have a tendency of couponing by myself. Or sometimes I may meet a person in the store and I have an extra coupon. I'd be like, I got a coupon for this. Here you go. And they'd be like, oh, thank you.
That's nice. I have a couple people at my Publix that'll sometimes do that. It's incredibly nice. And I always appreciate saving money too.
Those coupon fairies. When you meet someone in the store and they happen to give you a coupon, that is your coupon fairy.
They're my favorite coupon fairy godmothers. last question that we currently have. Anybody else have any questions? Please feel free to put them in the chat on Facebook. But the last one we currently have is, what is your favorite thing about couponing?
Favorite thing about couponing is getting the items for free. Free is the best way. When you can walk out the store and have, I'll give you another example. It was one time they had the toilet paper Quilted Northern on sale, and I had 8 packs, and it was the 6 = 12, so that made it be a total of 72 rolls of toilet paper, but it was 8 packs, and I end up paying $4 and some change, so I saved about $56.
Wow. That's amazing.
So when toilet paper when COVID hit and toilet paper was on limit supply, I was already stocked up.
Amazing.
Thank you.
All right. Well, that's the last of our questions. So we just want to say thank you to everybody who joined us today.
And I hope to see you on September the 10th. Same time, same location. Okay. Bye-bye,
thanks,
everyone.
Everybody.
Bye-bye.